Welcome. This video illustrates how to install Usage Meter 3.6. Start by downloading the Usage Meter appliance from the myvmware.com site. Once the appliance is downloaded, the OVF file can be deployed using the vSphere web client or the OVF tool. Select the OVF file downloaded from myvmware.com and accept the license agreement. Enter a name for the Usage Meter deployment and select a target. Select a storage location for the appliance disk and select the target network. Enter initial passwords for the appliance root and usage meter users. Last, set the static IP for the appliance. If DHCP will be used, change the network setting to DHCP. Once the command completes, the appliance is deployed to a vCenter server but is not started. Usage Meter requires a network protocol profile to define its network properties. The network profile is required for the appliance to successfully power on. If using a static IP for the appliance, enter and verify values for the network subnet, subnet mask, and gateway. Next, we'll check the VApp properties to confirm the settings made by the deployer. We see that the root and usage meter appliance users were set during deployment. The network properties display the configured static IP. If DHCP is required, change the IP allocation to DHCP. At this point, we're ready to finally power on the appliance. Once the appliance is started, click on the console and then select the Set Time Zone entry. Here we set the time zone for the appliance to the correct value for the usage meter location. Once this is done, we log in using the root ID and restart the Tomcat service. The web UI is accessed using an admin user. Run the webpass command to set the password value for the admin user. Next, log off and open the Usage Meter web app using a browser in the URL displayed on the console page. Log into the Usage Meter web interface using the admin account and password set with the webpass command. Next, the user must accept the data sharing terms to continue. Starting at the Provider tab, enter the service provider information. All of the information must be supplied since the data is used in both reporting and email communications. Next, select the Email tab. The email server is used to send usage information to VMware and alert notifications to the provider administrator. The user and password entered are used to authenticate with the mail server. Once the settings are validated, they can be saved. Next, switch to the Products tab. On this page, we configure each product that Usage Meter will monitor. For this video, a single vCenter will be added. Enter the location and credentials for the server. Next, accept the certificates for the server. Usage Meter connects to the server and adds the entry to the list of monitored servers. Next, switch to the License tab. Usage Meter discovers licenses associated with infrastructure that it is monitoring. Ensure that the license type for monitored infrastructure is set to VCAN. As a last optional step, generate a monthly usage report. At this point, initial data collections have not been performed, so many report entries will have zero values. Verify that the expected infrastructure to be metered is contained in the report. This completes the video. Thank you for watching.